and welcome to our Yin Yoga practice today. Yin Yoga, in opposition of Yang Yoga, which is what we are typically practicing. In Yin, we allow ourselves to soften into the pose, relax the muscles, and we're working not to strengthen the muscles, but to strengthen the connective tissue. So as we come into a pose, we hold the pose for a relatively long period of time. We're relatively still, and we find a level of stress in the position, somewhere on a scale of 1 to 10, about a stress level of 4 or 5. Always avoiding pain, but always entering into the pose, softening into it, and letting the whole body drape into the pose. There'll be target areas in the poses, and so the whole idea of putting that stress on the connective tissue is to increase the production of collagen by activating the fibroblast in the connective tissue. So let's enter into our yin practice today. So let's first start with toes of fire. Let's turn all the toes under and then just gently sit back on the heels, bringing hands maybe to heart center. Breathing in through the nose and out through the nose, abiding in our pose, not striving in any way. If this is too intense, we can always come up, or we can put a block under the hips or a blanket across the calves. Beautiful, and let's release, and let's come up to a straddle position. So widening the legs, and in our yang practice, we would be tightening the legs and the toes would be towards the sky, but in the yin, the muscles are relaxed and the feet fall out to the side. In yang, we would be bringing the heart center forward and hinging. But in the yin, we allow the back to curve and draw the upper body towards the floor. So as we come into our straddle, which is called dragonfly in the yin, let us just come into the pose and be softening into the pose, finding a place with a bit of stress there for the connective tissue. The target areas being the inner thighs and the lower back. And today I'll be reading the Japanese garden. Be the still pool. Let your face reflect the glory, the wonder. once release, coming back up. And bring the hands behind the hips and the feet to the outside edges of the mat. And hinging the knees, rolling them from side to side. Moving the prana throughout the body, moving the energy, the chi. And then coming back to dragonfly and bringing the right foot into the left for half butterfly. Again, relaxing the muscles of the legs and just drawing ourselves forward towards the floor. Just letting the weight of the upper body draw you closer. Staying here relatively still and for a relatively long period of time. Be the bud. Prepare to blossom. Releasing, coming back up, taking the right leg out and bringing the left foot in, relaxing the muscles and just letting the upper body drape and draw you closer to the earth, softening into the pose. Relaxing all the muscles, noticing the targeted areas in the hips, the back, the inner thigh. Be the tree, grant shelter. And when you're ready, coming back up and coming into butterfly, the soles of the feet together. And in yin, we would have hands around the ankles and elbows into the thighs, and we would be hinging forward in butterfly. But here, We round the back and draw ourselves a little closer to the earth. Finding the pose where we're softened, where we can stay for several minutes, relatively still. And as the muscles relax and open up, we might find ourselves being drawn towards the floor a little more. And just go with that. Be the butterfly. Accept the riches of the moment. Be the butterfly. Fingertips behind the hips, feet on the floor, maybe lifting up through the heart center, maybe lifting the hips into reverse tabletop, or maybe somewhere in between, or just moving between tabletop and bringing the hips down, providing an opportunity for the energy to flow throughout the body. And now we're going to come and face the floor, come down on our bellies, and come into Sphinx pose. So our forearms are parallel to each other. And in our yang practice, Sphinx would look like this, drawn up through the crown of the head, a lot of space between the shoulders and the ears. But in yin, our Sphinx pose looks like this. We let the shoulders and the ears come closer together. We let the head fall towards the floor. We soften into the Sphinx pose and the target area being in the shoulders. And the other target area is in the mid-spine. You might feel a bit of compression there. Be the moth. Seek the light. Relatively still, relatively long periods of time. And then let's bring ourselves up. Now let's take the left forearm to be parallel to the front of the mat. And we're going to take our right leg out to the side. And we bend the left foot and reach the right hand back to find the left foot into cattail. We can turn on our spine and look towards the right foot, or maybe the left foot. And as we're here, be the lantern, guide the lost. Release, coming back to Sphinx, and coming to the other side for cattail, so the right forearm parallel to the front of the mat, the left leg coming out to the side. We're resting sort of on the top outer part of the right thigh, and bending the right leg, reaching back with the left hand to find the foot in cattail. Be the path. Open the way for others. Let's release and come back to Sphinx pose. And then pushing our way back up, let's come to a couple of cat-cows. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, taking a breath in, lifting the face, the tailbone, exhaling into cat. And then we're going to come into a position called quarter dog or melting heart. So the knees are right under the hips and we begin to walk the hands out. So I might need to step back a little bit more. We're opening the shoulders and taking the ears inside the arms. And maybe we let the heart melt down towards the floor. Thus the name, melting heart. So there's opening and tension and stress in the shoulders. There's some compression in the mid part of the spine. These are the target areas. So again, only find that place where you can stay for a relatively long period of time and relatively still, and finding that stress level somewhere between 1 and 4 on a scale of 1 to 10. Be the wind chime. Let the breeze blow through you. Turn the storms into song. And when you're ready, coming back up. And coming back now to bring the left foot forward to what we would call kneeling lunge in our yang practice, but here we call it baby dragon. We want the left knee right above the ankle. And in the yang version, the legs are engaged and so forth, and maybe we drag the foot and the knee towards each other. But in the end, we let the muscles relax and we take the weight of the upper body and rest it against the thigh, pushing the weight of the upper body into the thigh, the hands down, and the head dangles from the spine. So the target areas here are the left hip and the top of the right thigh. Be the rain. Wash away. Cleanse, forgive. Be the grass. Grow back when trod upon. Release down and step back into down dog. When we hold the poses in yin, our body can become sort of stressed to a point where we just need to move them and stretch everything out again and move the energy through the body. And let's bring it back down. And let's come into child's pose. And in this practice of yin, we take the knees wide and the toes together. So it's the target area of the inner thighs. We draw the hips back and we allow the body to relax and sink towards the floor. Come up from our child's pose and come to baby dragon on the other side, bringing the left foot forward, the right foot forward, the left knee back, hands down on the floor, maybe on blocks, and the weight of the upper body resting against the right thigh. And letting the head drop towards the floor. Be the bridge. Reach in peace to the other side. Come up and come into our high lunge, our high dragon. Arms overhead, sinking the hips down towards the floor. Be the moss. Temper your strength with softness and mercy. Bring the hands back down and step back to down dog. Pedaling the legs. And coming around now to seated position. For shoelace. So let's bring the left foot back towards the glute and maybe the right knee stacking on top of the left. Or if that's uncomfortable, bringing the left leg out and the right leg on top. Relaxing the legs, and we hinge forward into shoelace. This would be similar to our Turkish twist pose in our yang practice. Be the soil, bear fruit. And when you're ready, coming up, switching to the other side. Finding a version of shoelace where you can stay for a relatively long period of time, relatively still. The target area in the hips. Be the gardener, create order. And when you're ready, coming back up. Coming once again with the feet to the outside edges, hands behind. Windshield wiping the knees from side to side. Once again to butterfly, a gentle hinging forward. And coming back up. And then coming all the way down to the floor for Shavasana. Maybe the feet wide today, the knees resting together. Maybe the legs extended long. Bring awareness to the breath, to the softness of the breath, to the stillness within the heart. Be the still pool. Let your face reflect the glory, the wonder. Be the bud. Prepare to blossom. Be the tree. Grant shelter. Be the butterfly. Accept the riches of the moment. Be the moth. Seek the light. Be the lantern. Guide the lost. Be the path. Open the way for another. Be the temple. Let the spirit dwell in you. Be the moon. Shine through the darkness. Be the pebble. Let time shape and smooth you. Be the leaf. Fall gracefully when your time comes to let go. Trust in the circle. To end is to begin. Be the temple. Let the spirit dwell in you. When you're ready, gently rolling to one side and resting there, observing the emotions in the body, just taking a bit of inventory, noticing the calm, noticing the peacefulness, noticing the stillness. Returning to a seated position. Stretching out the neck from side to side. and left ear towards the shoulder, and to the right, and releasing, taking the breath up, and drawing hands to heart center. Be the temple. Let the spirit dwell in you. Namaste.